Why are events like this that celebrate and support independent storytelling so special and important?
I think obviously commercial cinema has a lot of support all the time, and its sort of focus is trying to make those bigger budget projects. So independent cinema is really important just because it gives other artists and sort of newer creatives a chance to sort of break in. But I think it also gives an opportunity to tell different kinds of stories, and maybe to a sort of more niche audience or not as global an audience. So I think it's important in that respect too. It's all about storytelling, isn't it, at the end of the day? So on All Four at the moment, Catch 22, George Clooney's series is on, that he did as a limited series, and I was really fortunate to be in a few episodes of that. I was directed sort of by George, did episode 1 and 6, and also Ellen Kuras, who's an amazing DP turned director. She's just fantastic. So it was really amazing being part of that project. So yeah, it's been out on Hulu. It's been out on Channel 4 just recently, and it's on catch up at the moment. So yeah, check it out.
I mean, obviously, for so many years, it was deemed an unfilmable masterpiece. What do you think it is, as a storyteller, the qualities that George has that made him the right person to take on that challenge of bringing Hela to screen?
Well, Luke Davis, who wrote it, who wrote Lion, and David Michaud, I mean, both fantastic talents. It's been considered unfilmable for a long time, right? But I think we're at that time in history now with our TV and filmmaking where there's lots of ground being broken. So it's a really tight script. It's a really timely piece, I think, because it's all about that kind of toxic masculinity and how heroism is built up to be a certain type of thing. And Yossarian is a character who really is really honest with the audience and says, yeah, I feel scared. So it's quite important to sort of see a TV show like that at a time like this, I think, yeah.
Can talk a little bit about working with George, because obviously, I mean, people are very familiar with him as an actor, but I think as a director, he's rapidly establishing himself as a very significant talent as well.
Oh, he's an incredible filmmaker. I think, for me, I loved Confessions of a Dangerous Mind when he made that. He's been a fine director for years. What was really exciting is to go onto a set with someone you admire so much and them not disappoint in any way. He was just so incredible, very charming, and really sort of concise with what he's after. So there's none of that sort of wasting time trying to work out what you're trying to do. George was just very assertive, very kind, and very collaborative. And I think for a director and actor of his caliber to still offer that for the likes of me, for example, I thought it was really, really powerful. So yeah, amazing.